This video demonstrates the steps to configure PiVision 2020 after installation. It is divided into the following sections. First, we want to make sure that the PiData archives and AF servers that we want to connect to in Vision are listed in our known servers table. On the PiVision web server, open PiSystem Explorer and click File, then click Connections. I'm going to confirm that I can connect to my data archive by selecting the server and clicking Connect. To add additional AF servers, click Add Asset Server, enter the name of the AF server in the host field, click Connect, and OK. Similarly, to add PiData archives, click Add Data Server, enter the name of the PiData archive in the host field, click Connect, and OK. Next, there are three local user groups that were created when PiVision was installed. These groups control who has access to different PiVision components. Open Computer Management, expand Local Users and Groups under System Tools, and select Groups. The PiVision Admins, PiVision Users, and PiVision Utility Users groups were all created when PiVision was installed. The PiVision Admins group controls access to the PiVision admin site and by default contains the user who installed PiVision. The PiVision Users group controls access to the PiVision site and by default contains authenticated users. The PiVision Utility Users group controls access to use the PiVision Display Utility, which is installed with PiVision, or the PiProcessBook to PiVision Migration Utility, which is a separate installation. By default, this group also contains the user who installed PiVision. To add domain users or groups to a PiVision local group, double-click the group, click Add, enter the name of the domain user or group account, click Check Names, then click OK and Apply. To remove existing users or groups from a PiVision local group, double-click the group, select an existing member, click Remove, and Apply. Be sure to update all of these PiVision local groups with your necessary domain users and groups. Next, we will check the SQL permissions before attempting to create the PiVision SQL database automatically. On the SQL Server, open SQL Server Management Studio and connect to the SQL Server instance. Note the SQL Server instance name, which will be needed for the PiVision admin site. The full name will be located at the top of the Object Explorer pane, and it might end with SQL Express. Next, verify that this SQL server has allow triggers to fire others set to true. To check this, right-click the SQL instance and go to Properties. Under Advanced, confirm that allow triggers to fire others is set to true. Additionally, the user accessing the PiVision admin site must have specific permissions on the SQL server to be able to create the PiVision SQL database. Expand Security, Logins, right-click the user account, and select Properties. Click Server Roles and confirm that the DB Creator server role is selected. Alter Any Login permission is also required, which is given to users who have the Security Admin server role. After verifying that my user account is in the PyVision admins group and has the appropriate permissions on the SQL Server, we will navigate to the PyVision admin site on the PyVision web server. Right-click the web browser and select Run as Administrator. Then enter the PyVision admin site URL. By default, the PyVision admin site will be located at https://webserver/pyvision/admin, where web server is the name of the PyVision web server. Alternatively, open IIS Manager, expand Sites, the site where PyVision is installed, in my case, default website, PyVision, and select Admin. In the Actions pane, click Browse HTTPS. Note that navigating to the PyVision admin site via IIS Manager will use localhost in the URL, which might not be included in the certificate subject alternative name. In the Overview page of the PyVision admin site, click Manage Configuration next to PyVision Database. In the SQL Server field, use the dropdown or manually enter the name of the SQL Server instance to host the PyVision SQL Database, which was found in SQL Server Management Studio. In the Database field, enter the name of the PyVision SQL Database to be created on the SQL Server. Click Save to create the PyVision SQL Database and verify green check marks appear next to the fields. If you are not able to create the PyVision SQL Database using the PyVision admin site, you may create the PyVision SQL Database manually. Please see the Run the go.bat script to configure the PyVision Database section of the PyVision Installation and Administration Guide for details. The next step in the PyVision admin site is to add the data archives and AF servers that we want to be exposed in PyVision. In the PyVision admin configuration page, click the Data Servers tab. Here, the data archives from the Known Servers table on the PyVision web server are shown. To verify connectivity to a data archive, click Test Connection and make sure a green check appears in the status. Select the Allow checkbox next to each data archive to be used in PyVision and click Save. Next, click the Asset Servers tab in the PyVision admin configuration page. To verify connectivity to an AF server, click Test Connection and verify a green check appears in the connection status. Select the checkbox next to each AF database to be used in PyVision, or select the All checkbox to allow access to all databases for each AF server. Click Save when finished. Finally, click Overview to go back to the PyVision admin overview page and verify green checks appear next to the PyVision SQL database, each data archive server, and each AF server. The last configuration item to set up in the PyVision admin site is PyProcessBook import folders. Click Import Folder Management. Here, we can set up specific folders, and the PyProcessBook displays that are added to that folder will get picked up and be available to view in PyVision. Make sure the PyVision application pool account has read access to any folder and its subfolders to be added in this page. To add a PyProcessBook import folder, enter the folder path in the folder field and optionally an alias in the friendly name field. Click Add. refresh the page and verify a green check appears in the Folder Accessible column. We have now created the PyVision SQL database and managed the PyVision local groups, in addition to configuring Data Archive, AF Server, and PyProcessBook import folder access using the PyVision admin site. In the next video, we will configure Kerberos delegation to allow users to access data archives and AF servers using Windows Integrated Security.